Hi, welcome back to my channel. As you know, the last class we were discussing about problems of the formulas which we have discussed, isn't it? Let me recall the formulas: cube, cuboid and cylinder we were discussing, and cuboid's total surface area is 2 into lb plus bh plus lh, its volume is lbh, and its lateral surface area is 2 into LH plus BH. Then cube, its total surface area is 6 a square and lateral surface area is 4 a square and its volume is a cube. And cuboid's volume is L into B intersection. And cylinder's total surface area is 2 pi r into H plus R and its curved surface area is 2 pi RH and volume is pi R square H. All those things we have discussed, and last class we discussed few direct questions, very simple questions based upon that formula. And today is very special day for us because we are going to wind up 8th standard maths today. So that means by discussing few standard question, we are going to shut down this chapter, and in that way we will wind up 8th standard maths. That means this is going to be the last video from 8th standard. Is it clear for you? Okay. So, without wasting much time, let me go to the questions. I have selected 3 standard questions for you, and let us try to solve that 3 standard question, and let us try to think in order to solve that question which concept we must apply to solve out that questions. Shall we? Stay with me, don't go anywhere, do not skip the video, because today we are going to discuss, as I mentioned, very, very, very important problem. Shall we? Yes. This is your first question. Find the amount of, write the question, very important question. Find the amount of air inside a cuboidal box with the sides 15 centimeter and 20 centimeter. Let me repeat the question. Find the amount of air inside a cuboidal box with the sides are given as 10 centimeter, 15 centimeter and 20 centimeter. You know, here the meaning of the question is, you may understand the meaning of the question. We are supposed to calculate the amount of air inside a cuboidal box. The amount of air is nothing but, you know, how we can calculate amount of air? Amount of air is nothing but its volume. I already mentioned that volume, the one of the example of the situation volume is the amount of air inside a vessel, or amount of sand inside, or amount of water inside a vessel. Although in all those cases we will use the concept of volume. So here we are supposed to use the concept of volume. So what we can write? Amount of air inside what? Cuboidal box is given by its volume. No, its volume, it is nothing but its volume. Its volume formula, it's a cuboidal box. So which is the formula for calculating volume? L into B into H. So here L is given as 10, B is given as 15 and H is given as 20. How do you know that L is 10 and B is 15 and H is 20? Because it is given as sides are 10, 15 and 20. It means first one is L, second one is B and third one is H, height. Okay, so this will give you the result. So 10 into 15 is, you know, what is 15 into 20? 15 into 2 is 30. Then we have to add one more zero. So 15 into 20 is 300. Then 300, then here 110 is there. So 300 into 10 is 3000. So the answer is 3000 centimeter cube. The unit of the volume is always cube. Here the measurements are given in centimeters, so the unit should be centimeter cube. If the measurements are given in meter, the unit should be meter cube. So in this way, clear? So once again, the volume of a cuboidal box, the formula is given by L into B into H. L, B, H are given. 10 into 15 into 20, 15 into 2, 20 is 30. Okay, 300, then into 10, 3000, 3000 centimeter cube. So this much volume of air will be there inside the cuboidal box. So don't forget to write the conclusion, right? Conclusion as So the amount of air inside the cuboid box will be equal to 3000 centimeter cube. Is it clear? Okay. So moving to the next, second question. Clear. Find the amount to be paint on the caved surface of cylindrical pillar at the rate of 10 rupees for 1 meter square if its radius and heights are 7 meter and 70 meter respectively. Let me read the question once again. Find the amount to be painted on the caved surface of cylindrical pillar at the rate of 10 rupees for 1 meter square if its radius and heights are 7 meter and 70 meter respectively. It means that, you know, there exists a pillar, you know that pillar, you know, pillar, thoon, okay. There exists a pillar that is in the shape of cylinder. You know that thoon ennu parayumbodhu eppozhum mikkappozhum edaanu cylindrical shape ilaanu thoon velliyoru thoon aanu vicharikkam. Clear? Its radius and heights are given as 7 meter and 70 meter. Its radius is given as 7 meter, no, in the question. So this is what is 7 meter. So we can mention it as radius 7 meter and height is 70 meter. So this is what is its height. Here we can represent the height, that is 70 meter. It is given. And this is the case. Someone want to paint on the caved surface only, not total surface, only the caved surface, only the lateral surface or only the side surface only. Someone want to paint caved surface. Clear? Okay. So while someone is going to paint caved surface, then which concept we have to use there? Painting is nothing but surface area, because painting can be done on the surface, no? So painting means we are supposed to use the case of or the concept of surface area. Here which surface is going to paint? Caved surface. So what concept we have to find out? Caved surface area is the concept we have to explore. So caved surface area. Now, what we can write? So, caved surface area is equal to, what is the formula for calculating caved surface area? It is a cylinder. Caved surface area is 2 pi r h. 2 pi r into h is the formula for calculating caved surface. Clear? 2 pi r h is the formula. Then what we can do is substitute every value which is given. 2 into pi value I am going to substitute as 22/7. Then r is nothing but radius, which is given as 7 meter, and h is nothing but at 70. It is given as 70. Is it clear for you? Now 7 and 7 will get cancelled. Multiply all the remaining. 2 into 22, 44. 44 into 70. What is 44 into 70? What is 44 into 7? 308. So 44 into 70 will be 3080. This much meter square, because it is some area, the unit should be meter square. If the measurements are in meter, meter square. If the measurements are in centimeter, centimeter square. So this much meter square is the area we have to paint. This much meter square is the area we have to paint. But here not the here the question is not to calculate the area. We are supposed to calculate the amount. That means for lay base in the sense those who are going to paint on the pillar. Okay, so for the lay base we have to pay an amount of, when they paint 1 meter square area, we are supposed to give 10 rupees to them. I repeat, for the lay base, when they paint 1 meter square area, then we are supposed to give 10 rupees to them. Okay, that means for 1 meter square, we have to pay an amount of 10 rupees. Then how much meter square we actually must paint? This much meter square is the area that lay base must paint. Why? Because this is its caved surface area. That lay base must paint caved surface. So how much area the lay base must paint out? Paint. This is the area. they must paint. For 1 meter square, we have to give 10 rupees to the labourers. Then this much meter square they are going to paint out. So let me ask you a question. Why I am repeatedly saying that this much meter square is the area they have to paint? Because of the reason that the labourers must paint all the caved surface. So this is what is caved surface area. So this is the area which they have to paint. When they paint 1 meter square area, we have to give 10 rupees. So for this much meter square, how much amount we have to pay? For 1 meter square, 10 rupees. Then what is for 2 meter square? 2 into 10. What is for 3 meter square? What amount we have to pay? 3 into 10 rupees. Because for 1 meter square, 10 rupees we have to paint. So in short, for 3080 or 3080 meter square, we have to give an amount. So total amount to be paid is equal to what? For 1 meter square, 10 rupees. Then for this much meter square, this much into 10. Isn't it? For 1 manjin 10 rupees, 10 manjin ethraya? Allekil 100 manjin ethraya? 1 manjin 10 rupees. Then 100 manjin ethraya? 100 into 10. So just like that, for 1 meter square, 10 rupees. Then for this much meter square, this much into 10. That means 3080 into 10 is the amount we have to pay. That means 30800 rupees. That means 30,800 rupees we must give. Clear? So last question. Read the question carefully. Ramu and Radha. Okay. Ramu and Radha. They have water bottles. Clear? In the shape of cupboard and cylinder. Ramu's water bottle with the dimension 7 cm, 6 cm and 20 cm, and Radha's bottle with the diameter and height are 14 cm and 21 cm, whose bottle will hold more water? Adayat, what is the meaning of the question? Ramu and Radha, they are thick friends and they are neighbors too, and they are going to school together and they are returning from school together. Okay, they are childhood friends. Ramu's water bottle is in the shape of cuboid. It is given in the question. His water bottle is almost in the shape of cuboid. Cuboidal water bottle. Whereas Radha's water bottle is in the shape of cylinder. Clear? And Ramu's water bottle with the dimension what? 7 cm into 6 cm into 20 cm. That means this 7 cm into 6 cm into 20 cm stands for length is nothing but 7, breadth is nothing but 6, and h is nothing but 20. That means this is what is length, no? This is what is length. That length is given as 7. And this is what is breadth. That breadth is given as 6. And this is what is height. That height is given as 20. 7 into 6 into 20. Clear? Then, Radha's water bottle with the dimension, its diameter is given as 14 cm. You know, we know that radius is half of the diameter. I repeat, radius is half of the diameter. Then if the diameter is 14 cm, then what will be the radius? Because we need radius. Radius will be half of the diameter, that will be 7 cm. And height of the water bottle is given as 21 cm. That means h is given as 21 cm. Is it clear? Question is, whose water bottle will hold more water? That means we are supposed to compare the what we have to compare. The question is, whose water bottle will contain more water? That means, is it Ramu's water bottle or Radha's water bottle? Which contain more water? So, the concept we have to use here is, yes, you are right, volume. Why? Because this is a case of filling water, where we have to use the concept of volume. That means, just calculate the volume of this water bottle and calculate the volume of this water bottle. Which volume is bigger, that water bottle will hold more water. That means let me calculate volume of Ramu's cuboidal, isn't it? Cuboidal means cuboid. Cuboidal water bottle. That means let me calculate the volume of Ramu's cuboidal water bottle. That means I am going to calculate the amount of water which we can hold, which we can fill in Ramu's water bottle. That is what is volume. Volume of Ramu's cuboidal water bottle. Since it is in the shape of cuboidal, cuboid, the volume formula is L into B into H. That means 7 into 6 into 20. That means 42 into 20. 42 into 2 is 84, so 840. Clear? 840 centimeter cube is the volume of water which we can fill in Ramu's water bottle. Whereas in the case of Radha, the volume of Radha's water bottle is given by, it is in the shape of cylinder, so its volume is given by the formula pi r square h. Pi you can substitute as 22 by 7. Is it clear for you? Is it clear for you? Okay. Then radius. Radius is 7. So radius square means 7 square or 7 into 7. Isn't it? Radius square means radius is given as 7. So 7 square, that is 7 into 7. Then h. What is h? 21. So you can cancel this 7 and 7. What will remain? 22 into 7 into 21 will remain. Shall we calculate this? Its volume is 3234 centimeter cube. Compare both volume. You know, this is just 840 only. This is 3234. So it will contain more water. That means Radha's water bottle will hold more water when we compare to Ramu's water bottle. Clear? So this is the answer for the question. I think this question is clear for you. So you are supposed to expect this kind of question in your annual exam. So all the best for your annual exam, and wishing you a very, very healthy 9th standard. Thank you. ഈ വർഷം മൊത്തം ഞാനയച്ച വീഡിയോ ക്ഷമയോടെ കണ്ടിരുന്ന എല്ലാ കുട്ടികൾക്കും ലോട്ട്സ് ഓഫ് ലവ് ആൻഡ് യു നോ ഫ്രം മൈ സൈഡ് ആൻഡ് താങ്ക്സ് ടു ഓൾ ഫോർ സ്റ്റേയിങ് വിത്ത് മീ ത്രൂ ഔട്ട് ദിസ് ഇയർ ആൻഡ് സോ വി ആർ ഗോയിങ് ടു മീറ്റ് ഇൻ 9th സ്റ്റാൻഡേർഡ് ഇറ്റ്സ് യുവർ ഷിബിൻ സാർ സൈനിങ് ഔട്ട് ബൈ